Hill herself, as we speak, is the executive director of Syracuse's Vera House. News Channel 9's Andrew Donovan speaking with her earlier today. Andrew, why is she there?
Randy Bregman is Congressman John Katko's guest from the district, and it's not the first time these two have joined forces.
I'm not sure if that's different, if it's a tunnel and then the grid.
A quick 24 hours after debating Interstate 81's future in Auburn, Representative John Katko will be part of a joint session of Congress for President Donald Trump's State of the Union address. Sitting next to Katko will be Randy Bregman.
I'm here in Washington, D.C., incredibly excited about the opportunity to join Congressman Katko as his guest at tonight's State of the Union event.
She's the executive director of Vera House, a safe haven for women victimized by domestic or sexual abuse. Its home is James Street in Syracuse, but a huge amount of its funding comes from Washington.
It's a wonderful opportunity to focus on our joint efforts to ensure the passage of a comprehensive bipartisan reauthorization of the Violence Against Women Act.
Bregman teamed up with Katko last fall to call attention to the pending expiration of the Violence Against Women Act, which helps victims of sexual assault, domestic abuse, and stalking, and provides critical funding to Vera House's services. Just when it was set to expire twice, it received last-minute temporary extensions until it's set to expire again in just 10 days.
And I'm taking her because I want to raise the issue about the Violence Against Women Act. It needs to be reauthorized permanently, and she's a perfect spokesperson for us.
Now Katko and Bregman are teaming up again to push for a much longer extension. In Syracuse, Andrew Donovan, News Channel 9.
Well,